Alright, first thing we're gonna do this morning, gonna work on these nasty looking headlights. They're both the same way, and it looks like even the deflector off the headlight bulb got knocked down here. I'll get that out later, but what I have to start with is 600 grit. We'll do 600, then we'll probably do 1200, and then I have 3000 Trizac pads. So let me get my thing set up here. Alright, using my DA, gotta hook it and a foam interface pad. It goes over the contours a little better, so you're not like sanding stripes. And then you gotta keep tipping your pad back and forth, you know, to get it on there flat. Well, we'll go ahead and give this a shot. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go over to the other headlight so we don't have to take our paper off. Alright, now we got 1000 grit. Feels totally different than the 600. This stuff is not paper. It's almost like a thin sheet of plastic. See, it looks a lot clearer now. Alright, that's 600, 1000. Now we're fixing to do 2000 wet. I'm just going to use my hand for these headlights. Get my thing on the spray. We're not doing body work because we're going to do another step after this. So a sanding block isn't really necessary on this part. Make sure you push down nice and flat. I mean, just and you want to do this for probably a good 3 or 4 minutes to get those 1000 grit scratches out. You can see the difference when we're done sanding here. Now, you never want to sand your car like this, because it'll leave streaks. The three fingers will leave streaks. We've got another stage we're going to do these headlights in yet. So just to do this here is going to be fine. See how close we're getting now? One more time and check them out. This really kills your shoulders and your clavicle and everything else trying to sand this out. Okay, let's wipe it off and see what it looks like, see if we need to do more. Let it dry a minute. I'll go do the other headlight and we'll come back. Okay, now I'm going to use a 3000 grit foam Trizac pad. Okay? This thing's probably an eighth of an inch thick, maybe 16th of an inch. I'm going to stick it to my interface pad or interference pad or whatever you want to call it. Try not to drop it on the floor. Now, you only need a little bit of water for this. You don't need a lot. And the other thing you're going to need, the air compressor turned on. I've been doing this the whole time with the compressor on. Okay, we got the compressor built back up. It's an 80 gallon tank, so it runs quite a bit. Ah, oh good, it didn't follow the floor. Yeah, that's the problem I got with this thing. I don't know if anybody knows anything about these pads with the stick-it. This is a 3M stick-it for your DA. Yeah, you can see the little fuzzies, okay? My sandpaper sticks to this, okay? But if you go soft side to here, it won't stick. If you go this side, rough side to rough side, it sticks. But then the paper doesn't stick. I mean, it doesn't make any sense. I don't know what the hell the deal is. I've never had a stick-it DA before, so I just kind of make do with it. It works all right. This is 3,000 grit. I actually make these in 5,000 grit also. I'm going to order me a couple of them off. My water bottle. I'm going to show you the difference between 2,000 and 3,000. Ouch. Okay. By the way, I'm using my HDR CX7 today. My wife drove off in the car and took my HDR CX110 with it. She won't be back till this afternoon, so I have to use this one. All right, that's 2,000 grit, wet sanded. You can see you can't even hardly see through that, okay? This is 3,000 grit. It's absolutely super smooth. I mean, just slick to the touch, ready to buff. Okay, I'll go ahead and do the other headlight and then we'll go ahead and buff it. All right, this is what we're gonna use to do the headlights with, and a buffer app, obviously. Headlight, turn that buffer down, got it on 1,000. To finish, 30 minutes is all it took. I mean, you can see how clear that thing is. I mean, you can see right through it now. It looks good now. Those headlights from Volkswagen are like $320 a piece, I think. You can get a pair of aftermarket ones from China. Probably $150 for a pair. As long as these things aren't broke. These are your adjusters. If those aren't broke, which 99% of them are, I don't know why these aren't. That's why I polished them, because the adjusters are in good shape. So I'll go ahead and get this one polished, and we'll be done with it. Okay, I got that one done. You remember how nasty they were? Okay. And then that's it. You can actually go over them with some machine glaze or some other kind of lighter polish that just doesn't have any kind of grit in it. And then that would finish them off. There you go.